All right, we are looking at, this is 3-36. This is from 3.1.4, and this is CC3. So CC3, 3.1.4, number 3-36. It wants us to take another rule. In this case, the rule is y is equal to x squared, and complete the table. As well as then go from there, we're going to plot the points on a graph and talk about what we see here. So y equals x squared. Remember, y equals x squared is the same thing as y equals x times x, right? X squared is multiplying, anything squared is multiplying itself twice, by itself, multiplying by itself, right? So we've got x squared is x times x. So my table, I'm going to do a vertical table. They have in the textbook a horizontal table. You can recreate the horizontal table, but I just tend to do a vertical table. So I end up with starting with the values of -4, and I'm going to find out what -3 is. When my inputs are these values here, they want me to find what my outputs are, my corresponding outputs based on the given inputs. So I'm going to rewrite all the inputs. And all right, so the table is ready. So at this point, what values do I get for my outputs based on those inputs? So remember, it's x times x is the rule. X squared, x times x, x squared. So -4 times -4 is a positive 16. -3 times -3 is a positive 9. -2 times -2 is a positive 4. Notice all of them are going positive because I'm multiplying the same sign twice. -1 times -1 is a positive 1. -1/2 times -1/2 is a positive 1/4. Right? Multiplying fractions, just a little side note. If I had 1/2 times 1/2, remember multiplying fractions, you just multiply straight across. 1 times 1, 2 times 2. 0 times 0 is 0. 1/2 times 1/2, 1/4. 1 times 1, 1. 2 times 2. Is 4, 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16. So there's my values. So now it wants me to scale appropriately a graph, a set of axes, and then create the graph itself. So I'm going to get out some graph paper here. And I'm looking at my values, and I'm seeing that I've got my y values up to 16. And then my lowest y value is 0. So I have no negative y values. So that being said, I can probably, when I draw my axes, I can draw them to where I just have mainly the first and second quadrant. I'm not needing this the negative quadrants for the y values. But here are my x's, right? So I know my x values are from -4 to 4. So I want to make sure I'm in enough. And I'm going to be, let's go 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, I can make this probably where my y-axis is. Okay, so I'll determine where the x-axis is in just a second. So this is going to be my y-axis. And I know I've got to get up to 16 on my y, so I'm going to count down 16. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 15, 16. So I can at this point make that my origin. Right, so that way I can get up to 16 on my y values. And I'll just draw my x axes. It's always nice to use a straight edge so you have nice lines. So this is my x axes, okay, right here. And then this is my y axes right here. Notice I have more space in my first and second quadrant, right? Because I mentioned there's no negative y values. So all my y values are going to be in the positive. So let's start plotting these points, right? The first point that I'm plotting, I'm going to work my way from the top of my table down, is -4. And I'm just going to write in my numbers. That's -1, -2, -3, -4. So therefore, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's my x scaled. So if I go to -4, I need to go up to 16. So just so that way I have some scaling on this too. I'm going to, that would be 1, this would be 2, This would be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm going to write in my values for my, that would be up to 16 up there, my values on my y-axis, so it's easier for me to find them when I'm plotting instead of counting every time. So I'm going up to negative 4 on the x-axis, and this is the y-axis, all the way up to 16, which I counted up already. So there's my first point, negative 4, positive 16. So then I have negative 3 on the x, positive 9 on the y. So that would be right here, just below, between the 10 and 8. I have negative 2 and positive 4, which looks like right here. And then I have negative 1, positive 1. I have negative 1 half, positive 1 fourth, so barely above there. And then I have 0, 0, which is my origin. And then a positive 1 half, positive 1 fourth, so again, barely above. And then a 1, 1, so positive 1, positive 1. Positive 2, positive 4. Positive 3, positive 9. Except right there. And then positive 4, positive 16, up to the 16. There we have it. So if I look at this pattern as far as what this looks like, I've got kind of this U shape. And that's exactly what this is. It's not a V where you're going to have straight lines, because you notice there's no, you can't draw an actual straight line. There's not a constant slope going on with each of these points. So it's more of a U shape. And notice the bottom tends to slowly curve, it's not a fast point. So I'm going to slowly curve the bottom and then work my way up to these points as a U shape. And then when we get to the top here, the question is, does it keep going? And it would, right? I could still put in a 5. I could put another value in a 5 and I would get 25. So it does keep going in this pattern. So this is where I tend to go right past my last points and add some arrows to show that that pattern continues. So that's what that pattern looks like. And if we read part B of this question, it then gives us some more information, and it says that the graph is an example of a parabola, and then it wants us to read about parabolas in the math notes. And then the vertex of the parabola that you graphed. So it wants to ask, where is the vertex? Well, the vertex, if you read the math notes, the vertex is either the very, very top or the very bottom of the parabola. In this case, since the parabola is shaped upward, right, we have this U shape upward, the very bottom of that parabola is right here at 0, 0. So for part B, I would say 0, 0 is the vertex. Okay, so 0, 0 is the vertex, and it wants us to know that. Okay, there you go.